Hello friends, welcome to UGPG Mathematics. In this video, I am going to solve problems from GATE 2020 Mathematics. So let's start. The question is, we have given phi a finite dimensional non-zero vector space over C and T is a linear map from V to V such that range of T is equal to null space of T, then which of the following is false? Option A is the dimension of V is even. Then second option is 0 is the only eigenvalue of T. Third option is both 0 and 1 are eigenvalues of T. And fourth option is T square is equal to 0. So let's start. By rank nullity theorem, we have dimension of V is equal to rank of T plus nullity of T. Now we have given that range of T is equal to null space of T. So rank of T, this is just equal to rank of T plus rank of T, because from this nullity of T is equal to rank of T. So this is equal to 2 times rank of T. Now rank of T is some number and dimension of V is equal to 2 times something, so it is even number. So the dimension of V is even. This is true. Now the second option is 0 is the only eigenvalue of T. Now we cannot say something about this, so let us just show that this T square is equal to 0. So this is very easy because we have to show that this T square x is equal to 0 for all x belongs to phi. Now see that this T square is a operator, linear operator from phi to phi. So this is our claim. So you take any phi, take any x belongs to phi, then this Tx belongs to range of T, right? And now what we have to prove, that T square x is equal to 0. So T square x is equal to T of x. Now this T of x, as we have said, this belongs to range of T. So this vector is in range of T. But we know that this range of T is equal to null space of T. So this T of x belongs to null space of T. But null space of T means what? When you apply T on that vector, we will get 0. So when we apply T on this vector T of x, we will get 0. Hence T square of x is equal to 0. And this V x was arbitrary. Hence T square of x is equal to 0 for all x belongs to phi. And hence this T square x is equal to 0 is satisfied. That means this option is also true. Now T square is equal to 0 means it is nilpotent operator, because we know that if T raised to k is equal to 0 for some V, for some k belongs to N, then this operator T is nilpotent. And here T square is 0, so it is nilpotent. And 0 is the only eigenvalue for nilpotent operator. Hence, this is also true. Now, 0 is the only eigenvalue of T. So, eigenvalue cannot be 1. And hence, this is false. And we have asked that which of the following is false. So, this is the correct option. Let's solve another question. The question is, if 4, 0 and 0, minus half are critical points of this function f of xy is equal to 5 minus alpha plus beta into x square plus beta y square plus alpha plus 1 into y cube plus x cube, where alpha and beta are real numbers, then this point 4, minus half is a point of local maxima of f. Second option is 4, minus half is a saddle point of f. third is alpha is equal to 4 and beta is equal to 2, and the last option is 4 comma minus half is a point of local minima of f. So let us find critical points. So fx is equal to 0 and fy is equal to 0 gives minus of alpha plus beta into 2x plus 3x square is equal to 0 and 2 beta y plus 3y square into alpha plus 1 is equal to 0. Now critical points are just the roots of this equation. So 4 comma 0 and 0 comma minus half should satisfy these two equations. So just put 4 comma 0 here. So we will get this as alpha plus beta is equal to 6, and now y coordinate is not there, so don't worry about this. Now put 0 comma minus half. So here y is not there, so just put 0 comma minus half in this equation. So it is 2 beta into minus half plus 3 into half square, minus half square is 1 by 4 into alpha plus 1 is equal to 0. So this gives us 3 alpha minus 4 beta is equal to minus 3. Now these are two equations in two variables, alpha and beta. By solving these two equations, we will get alpha is equal to 3 and beta is equal to 3. So alpha and beta are 3, so this is wrong because it is alpha equal to 4 and beta is equal to 2. Now just put the values of alpha beta in the function equation of function. So f of xy is equal to 5, alpha plus beta is 6, x square plus beta is 3, y square, alpha plus 1 is 4, y cube plus x cube. Now we have to find out the point of local maximum, or it is the point of local minimum. So at 4 comma minus half, so let this point AB is equal to 4 comma minus half. So let us define D is equal to fxx fyy minus fxy square. These are the second partial derivatives of f. Now we know that this fx is equal to this, so just find out these partial derivatives. So fx is equal to minus 12x plus 3x square, fy is 6y plus 12y square. So fxx is minus 12 plus 6x into fyy is 6 plus 24y, and the derivative of fx with respect to y or derivative of fy with respect to x is just 0, so 0 square is 0. Now you find out this D at point AB. So D at point AB is equal to minus 12 plus 6 into 4, 6 minus 24 by 2, and this is equal to minus 12 into 6, which is negative quantity, it is less than 0. So we know that if this D is less than 0, or D at AB is less than 0, then this point AB is a saddle point. So the second option is correct option. Let us solve another question. The question is, we have given xn is equal to xn minus 1 divided by 2 plus 3 upon xn minus 1 for n greater or equal 1 with x naught is greater than 0. Then the sequence xn, we have given four options. First is converges only if x naught is greater than 1. Second option is converges only if x naught is less than 3. Third is convergence for any x naught and does not converge for any x naught. So let us, it is about convergent of the sequence xn. So let us say that this sequence xn converges to say L. So that is limit of xn is equal to L. So this sequence converges, that means xn minus 1 converges to L. So just put the values here. So L is equal to L divided by 2 plus 3 divided by L. Now you solve this. So this is L is equal to L square plus 6 divided by 2L. So this gives us 2L square is equal to L square plus 6, that is L square is equal to 6, that means L is equal to plus or minus root 6. But here x naught is greater than 0, that means when you put n equal to 1, you will get x1 is equal to x naught by 2 plus 3 upon x naught. So as x naught is greater than 0, x1 is also greater than 0. Similarly, you can prove that xn is greater than 0 for all n. So it is a sequence of positive numbers, so it will not converge to negative numbers. So therefore L has to be plus root 6. So here this limit exists independent of x naught. So this sequence xn converges to root 6 independent of what is the value of x naught. So this converges for any x naught. Let us solve another question. The question is, the number of elements of order 3 in S6 is, now in S6 the order 3 elements are of the form A, B, C or A, B, C, E, D and F. That is, it is either a 3 cycle or product of 3 cycles. So when you take LCM of 3 and 3, you will get 3. So order of this is 3 and here it is just 3 cycles. So its order is 3. Now we have to count such 3 cycles. So we will use counting principle. So we have 6 elements because S is just a set of bijections from 6 element set to itself. So there are 6 elements. Now from these 6 elements, we want 3 elements for 3 cycle. So this can be done in 6 choose 3 ways, right? Now these 3 elements can be arranged in 3 factorial ways because there are 3 places for A, B and C. So these are 3 places and for these 3 places we want to arrange these chosen 3 elements. Now this A, B, C is same as B, C, A, which is same as C, A, B. That means this cyclic order does not matter. So we are counting this 3 cycle 3 times, so we just have to divide it by 3. So just simplify this, we will get 6 factorial by 3 factorial into 3 factorial into 3 factorial divided by 3, and this 6 factorial is 6 5 4 into 3 factorial, which is just equal to, so there are 43 cycles. Now case 2 is, we have product of 3 cycles. So there are 6 elements. From this, first you find the first you solve for this ABC. So 3 cycle, so we have to choose 3 elements as done before. This can be arranged in 3 factorial ways and we are over counting these 3 cycles, so divide again by 3. Now for this second cycle, we have to find 3 elements. Now there are total 6 elements and we have chosen these 3 elements, so the only three elements are remaining. So from these remaining three elements, you choose three elements and arrange them in three places, so three factorial ways. And again, you have to divide it by three, because as done before, this three cycle, we are counting it three times. So this is equal to this. Now, this ABC into EDF is same as EDF into ABC, because these two cycles are disjoint, so they commute. So you have to divide it by 2, and now you just simplify it, you will get this as 40. Now, by addition principle, because you have two choices, so by addition principle, there are 40 plus 40, which is 80 elements of order 3.